In the name of Allah, who is the most gracious and the most merciful. This is Kamran Ahmed, and I hope you are so well and enjoying the great Ramadan. Today, the topic that is assigned to me is very interesting and full of information. The name of my topic is Marriages in Pakistan. The word marriage is the word that gives us the sense of comfortness. Whenever we talk about marriages, it means that we are talking about the compromise between the two persons of different gender when they meet as a couple. If I say that marriages is the name of compromise, then it will be quite. If I say that the marriages is the name of compromise, then it will be quite right. If you see all over the world, then the marriages takes place in all part of the world, in every part of every country. It means the compromise may occur in every part of the world. Now question is that why the marriages occur? There may be so many reasons. Many people have many ideas. But as far as I am concerned, I am of the view that there may be so many reasons. For example, marriages may occur because of love, marriages may occur because of tradition, marriages may occur because of to increase the population, marriages may occur because to fulfill the religious obligation. We live in subcontinent, and subcontinent, this part of the world is quite different with the other part of the world, for example, Europe or Africa, etc. Pakistan is the major country of subcontinent, and more than 90% of population of Pakistan is Muslim. And so Muslim believe in Islam, in Allah. So the marriages occur here under Islam teachings. So the marriages that occur in Islam, Pakistan are quite different than the marriages that occur in Europe. The marriages that occur in Europe, they don't have any solid idea and solid reason behind this. For example, the marriage that occur in Pakistan, if we ask a couple that why did you marry, then they have reason. They may say that it's a religious obligation. We have married because to make Allah happy, etc. But in Europe, it doesn't occur. Islam is a complete religion. Islam is a code of conduct. Islam is the religion of code of conduct. For example, if Islam strictly prohibits a man to make illegal relationships with other person or a man. For example, Islam strictly against zina and welcomes nikah. Nikah is a marriage in Islam. The Muslims called nikah as a marriage. So nikah gives Muslim people so protection and you may say that confidence and respect a couple. Muslim Islams give respect to a lady, respect to a couple that is living in a society. But on the other hand, if we see that the divorce ratio is increasing day by day in Pakistan, I don't say that it is equal to as it is in Europe. But however, it is increasing. As a Muslim country, it is increasing in Pakistan. There may be so reasons. Actually, the persons who are living in Pakistan, they want the Muslims. Actually, the Muslims, they have changed their mind. They take Islam as a modern religion. They want modernism in Islam. But actually, Islam is needed in modernism. Islam was modern. Islam is modern, and Islam will be modern. Islam fulfills all needs of present time. Islam, if we study Islam, then we will come to know that Islam tells us four steps to choose our spouse. The number one is, if we want to choose a girl, if a boy wants to choose a girl or a girl wants to choose a boy, then he should take care of these four things that he take the help of these four things. For example, he may see his beauty, he may see his wealth, he may see his nobility and virtue. But unfortunately, we find these three things, four things, we basically three things, the fourth thing we skip. We don't need virtue. We see first three things, beauty, wealth, nobility. We want these three things. For example, if I say that, if I ask some person that why are you marrying that girl, he may say that I am marrying that girl because she's beautiful. But the second statement is, but that is fine right now, that I am marrying that beautiful girl because their beauty, their wealth, their nobility comes before because. However, it comes after because.
Okay.
But I think we should come to the solution. There are so many problems. We waste money on marriages, but the rebound, the product that is to be needed, that is to be found, we don't find it. For example, if a person marries, then we should find a healthy and happy home. But we don't find it. I think we should come to the solution. If I talk about solution, then the only reason that I know that I think is only to follow Islam. We have to follow our duties. Husband has to follow his duty for wife, and wife has to be follow duty for his husband. So the only statement that I want to say in the end, that follow what does Islam say.
Well done. Just clap for him, gentlemen.